Hey, how's it going, everybody? Sarasota Tim. I'm going to do it. I'm going to try it out for the first time in my life. In-N-Out Burger, here we come.
There it is in all its glory. I'm just going to ask him what to get. What's the most popular combo? Oh.
Head south.
No drive-thru access. Okay, back up.
So that was a little confusing for me. The guy was telling me that number one, the double-double is definitely the most popular. So I'm getting that with a Diet Coke. And then he said, would you like to know what our secret menu is, or secret ingredient or something? Or I don't know, some secret. And then he told me, and I couldn't quite understand it. I'm a little slow. And I said, so you're offering me something? He goes, no, I'm just telling you. I'm like, okay. And then he asked me if I would be eating in my vehicle, and I had to ask him again. I'm sorry, I'm hard of hearing. What'd you say? If I'll be eating in my vehicle. I said, yes, I'm definitely eating in this truck. I don't know why that question's asked me when I'm in the drive-thru. So this is definitely something different at the old In-N-Out. A truly different experience. Look at that. Look at this. This is a lap napkin as to why they asked me if I would be eating in my vehicle. So I guess you can't wait to get into that goodness. Like anywhere, you go through a fast food place and you immediately...
In 500 feet, turn left.
You pull
head
over
west,
and start eating.
Then turn left.
She's talking again, interrupting us. I am definitely going to get into this. Okay, so take a look at this. She asked me if I wanted some ketchup. I said, yes, I usually don't use it. I got a little salt here. Wonder how their fries. They're like little shoestrings. Look at that burger. I don't know what to do. Look at this thing. Are you kidding me? Look at this. I would say it's a pretty good looking burger. The fries are amazing. They're hot. I got ketchup and stuff. Well, let's get into it, and I'll give you my review after I finish eating. All right, my review. First, I got to stop into Boot Barn here and pick up something. My review is 5 out of 5. Oh, there's no turn here. There's no nothing. I'm in the wrong chance, Charlie. All right. 5 out of 5 on service, 5 out of 5 on cleanliness, a 5 out of 5 on courtesy, a 5 out of 5 on uniqueness, because the paper, the lap napkin placemat, the way they put everything in the wrapping to hold the burger, there's a wrapping, and then that is in another wrapping to hold the burger. Excellent. You don't make no mess. French fries, okay, I give a 3.5 out of 5. They're good, but I prefer thicker and crinkle fries. So you can't get a 5 if I like crinkle fries. The burger, while it tasted just fine, it was nothing absolutely special. In fact, because it had onions on it, all I tasted was onions. And I like onions, but they don't like me. So a 3.5 out of 5. So the food is 3.5 out of 5. The people, the service, the cleanliness, the uniqueness, the things they do on the speaker there when they talk to you and all that is great. So In-N-Out Burger is definitely worth stopping at. It's right on par basically with, I don't know, I'm probably going to get a hate for this, Wendy's. Way above McDonald's, but Wendy's is pretty good. I like Wendy's. I would rank it right around there. Nothing big, nothing special. I didn't like, wow, you know, thin burgers. I got the double-double, number one. Thin burger patties wasn't anything to, you know, make a big deal about. Now I got to go into Boot Barn and get a boot puller for my boots. Crush it.